The information shared in this episode is not intended to serve as a substitute for mental health services and is only intended to provide education and information to you, the listener. For tuning in to today's episode of the Honeybee Podcast. I have entitled today's episode, Promoting Resilience. The content for today is inspired by the countless amounts of clients that I've had the good fortune to work with over the course of my career. The people that I have in mind have experienced what many would consider traumatic, devastating, or chaotic circumstances. Perhaps while growing up, they witnessed domestic violence in the household or even violence in the neighborhood. Perhaps they observed their parents battling an addiction or their parents having severe symptoms related to a serious mental illness. Perhaps they grew up under-resourced or the survivor of interpersonal trauma. Whatever circumstances they faced during their formative years, while it was disruptive, stressful, and heartbreaking, through their resilience, they found a way to overcome the odds, the cards that were stacked against them. They found a way to not make their circumstances that were less than desirable and, again, stressful, chaotic, and disruptive, they found a way to not let those matters dismantle their ability to create a life worth living. The people that I am speaking of today, whether they are former clients of mine or not, perhaps you, the listener, have experienced various forms of adversity and not only found a way to survive that adversity, you were able to overcome it and become very accomplished, whatever your definition of accomplishment is to you. Resilience is related to how people respond to certain life events. In life, we will experience positive and negative things. And through those experiences, our ability to bounce back or be resilient is shaped. The resilient person has the inherent belief that they and not their circumstances are responsible for their achievements and their trajectory in their life. Aside from having that innate belief about their being their own orchestrator in life, there are some elements that are essential and helpful in the development of resilience. Let's call those things protective factors. The protective factors that I'm going to share in this episode enables us to achieve success despite the challenges we face. According to John Bowlby's attachment theory, a huge component of resilience or promoting resilience in a person, especially a child, is the concept of having a secure base. An example of a secure base would be healthy, functional relationships between a child and an adult, whether that be a parent, a caregiver, a coach, someone from the church itself. That is an example or are examples of a secure base. Having that sort of connection allows the person to attend or connect back with their secure base when they are in a state of crisis. This is the connection that allows us to feel safe due to consistent and predictable interactions within that or those relationships. While it is true that resilience can be developed and promoted all throughout one's lifespan, because we will go through various experiences that range from pleasant to adverse, to enhance my point in a way that will allow it to make sense, I'm going to be speaking about resilience in the context of a child in their formative years. in relation to my mentioning of how important it is for a person to have those rich, meaningful connections with an adult who is healthy and functional, it is important for that relationship, especially with the child being on the receiving end, it is important for the adult in that situation to be responsive to the concerns and needs of that young person in order to build a meaningful relationship that fosters trust, that enhances the relational bonds, and that will allow that child to shift their energy into different relationships and have the ability to create rich, meaningful relationships with others, expanding their social networks, enhancing their sense of self-worth, as well as their self-esteem. So to the adult who is listening to this message that is caring for a child or a teenager who has experienced numerous traumatic or chaotic or disruptive events in their life, your presence, your consistency, the ability for that child to be tethered to you relationally has created such a significant buffer to any long-term negative consequences from that adverse experience that took place more than you realize. So along those lines, with you being a consistent factor for the youth, an additional thing that is helpful for promoting resilience in a child is providing that child with the support and guidance that they need as they learn various skills and build a sense of mastery. A youth learning various things that are required in their daily lives from an adult who is trusted and well-intended will enhance the likelihood of that kid growing up to be a productive citizen. Learning how to clean their room, learning how to take a bath, learning how to drive a car, learning how to take care of animals, learning how to organize their lives in a well-balanced way. Having an adult alongside them during this journey, in spite of any negative experiences previously had, is tremendously beneficial and will promote resilience. During your teaching, during your modeling of behavior, you will intentionally or unintentionally teach that child how to regulate and tolerate stress surrounding various situations in an adaptive, positive, skillful way. As a quick recap, a person's innate belief that they are the orchestrators of their own life and of their own fate, in addition to having a meaningful, rich relationship with at least one consistent, healthy, well-functioning adult who is willing to support that child and guide them as they learn various skills that are required to be productive citizens, while consciously or unconsciously showing them how to tolerate stress effectively will promote resilience in that child. The final piece of information that is helpful as an additional element to promote resilience is using faith and cultural traditions as a foundation of stability and an additional arena to build positive experiences. Those things are the vital elements that will promote resilience in a child. So, a question, food for thought to you, the listener, those of you, really, those of us, who have experienced a set of adversities that at the time seemed like it would be difficult to overcome, at the time created a sense that life couldn't get any better. Some way, somehow, we found the will, we found the ability, we found the inspiration to create a life for ourselves that we determined to be meaningful and purposeful. Did you have anyone who was there for you that supported you along your journey, that without that person, that lighthouse in your life, your efforts of creating the life that you want would have been all the more complicated? If there was a person who was consistent, stable, and predictable, if there was a person in your life during the time or times that you experienced huge setbacks, were they willing to model appropriate behavior? Did they offer you wisdom that you could process, digest and manifest in whatever way you needed to for your own life? Did they offer you these things that helped you become the person that you are today? If you have the good fortune of being able to reach out to this person, I invite you to consider expressing your gratitude for their willingness to guide you along the way while you were on your journey of self-discovery and self-mastery. And if you are the person who is that lighthouse for a child who has experienced a set of adversities, even if you don't notice, the wisdom and the guidance that you are offering them to be utilized in the best way, please know that it is highly likely that all of those seeds you're planting will begin to blossom and bloom in a beautiful way. Thank you so much for tuning in to today's episode of the Honeybee Podcast. For the resources that I used for today's content, please check out the show notes. When you have a moment, please go to my website, myhoneybeetherapy.com. That is myhoneybeetherapy.com. Feel free to leave me a message with any feedback that is constructive and respectful. I would appreciate it. And again, I appreciate you for taking time out of your day to check out today's episode. Until next time, peace.